Hey guys, it's Danny. I am incredibly sick. I got the shivers, I got the fever, the headache, congestion. Yesterday was horrible. What to do, right? It kind of sucks because today was watering day, which I cannot perform. But it's okay, they're gonna be okay until tomorrow. I just didn't want to skip another day because I skipped Sunday. So today we're not gonna make an important video because I just can't. My neurons are in bed. They're asleep. I'm not entirely sure how coherent I will be, so we'll just take it easy. We're gonna make an update. How about we look at some orchids that we just didn't see in ages? Like, ages. Some of you that are new don't even know I have them, while some of you will be like, oh yeah, I remember you got that about 4 or 3 years ago. So let's do that, shall we? Okay, so as I'm pulling them out, I might just water them as well because it just makes me feel a little more useful. I'll see if I change my mind, but anyway. So let's start with the Sarcocyhlus fitzhart crossed with heart money. I'm not gonna pull the tag out because there are roots around it. Now this orchid is not necessarily super old. I got it a year and a few months ago, but I just didn't make any videos on it because it didn't really do much. It didn't do anything bad. It didn't do anything particularly nice either, in the sense that it didn't bloom. And these orchids, when they bloom, they're just so gorgeous. I was seriously thinking of buying more, but I wanted to see how I do with this one. And I'm not entirely sure what to say about it. So as you can see, we do have roots, and inside the pot there are roots. This orchid is very stable. She looks nice. The leaves she created, oh, she's a very slow grower, incredibly slow. Let me know, you guys, if you have this orchid, if you have a Sarcocyhlus, are they slow growers or do I have an issue with this one? I feel like she's growing very slow, Neophenicia type of slow. So she produced a few leaves ever since I got her, which look very nice, green and everything. She has a few shoots, basal shoots, and overall she's not doing bad, she's just not blooming. Then again, I only have her for about a year, so maybe I shouldn't expect much. I just feel like it's growing very slow, and I'm not entirely sure if this is how it should be or not. This is the only Sarcocyhlus that I have. It was my first orchid of the kind. I really don't have experience with it, so if you could let me know if she's a slow grower or any other details, do let me know. But there she is. We still have her and she looks pretty great. Nice green leaves, no blooms just yet. Alrighty, next up, well, this is a really old orchid. Almost 5 years ago, I purchased some orchids from Malaysia. If you don't know that very old video, check it down below, I'll add it. You can have a laugh, I'm very cringy, you know, the beginnings. Well, I still have her, shamefully, it doesn't look much different, does she? This is the biggest leaf she created this year, finally. I always kind of messed about with her and I always set her back, so I'm not surprised. It is completely my fault. I think I divided her as well and I shared those divisions with some people, so it's not her fault that she's still kind of tiny. I need to repot her, but she's doing quite okay right now. You can see she's in my old medium with Ceramis and Leca, and she's doing quite okay. I just feel she will do better in semi-hydro. My other Brassavolas certainly do. And the reason why I didn't repot her is because I thought she would bloom. This leaf being so long, so big, I thought, well, maybe it's time for her to bloom. I purchased her as a kind of a young plant, although she was bushy. The leaves she had weren't longer than this one. So I consider her to be a pretty young orchid, or at least she was. Now she's not young anymore. It's almost 5 years later and nothing much changed. That's my fault. But I was hoping this cane or this leaf would bloom. It didn't bloom. However, the orchid does look pretty great, you can see. And when I will repot her and put her into a more decent setup, then I hope she will finally start to develop. But there we go. Now here is another very old orchid which you might not even recognize. So again, about 4 or 4.5 years ago, one of my friends that I actually met through a forum decided to sell some of her collection because she needed the money. So I purchased from her all sorts of orchids which she ordered from eBay and things of the sorts. It was before I started to actually order all that much from eBay. Anyway, so she had a lot of orchids. Some of them were mislabeled, some of them didn't have a label, and this one was one of them. For an entire year, I thought this was the Ochreatum, but no. This is the Aphyllum slash Pierardi slash Cucullatum. Yes, it goes by three names. Choose one. I choose Aphyllum. I like it best. So this guy actually bloomed for me on a very tiny spike. I purchased him as a seedling, actually. It bloomed after a year with one little flower spike, but I just fell in love with him. It's one of those deciduous dendrobiums, and if you see the yellowing leaves, don't worry, it's supposed to do that. It's his season to lose leaves and flower. So I really, really liked him, and then afterwards I saw big specimens of this dendrobium in bloom. They are just some of the most gorgeous things you have ever seen. Just Google them. You have the names of all of these orchids in the description and with some old videos. So just expand the description, copy paste the names and Google them. So when I got him, he had very tiny little canes, and you can still see them in the back there. Do you see that? Let me show you how big they are. Not even as long as my palm. Well, this year, or actually last year, my little Aphyllum created his biggest pseudobulb. I don't think we're a seedling anymore. I think we are a juvenile, if that's what you call them. We're actually an adolescent. And of course, we have multiple buds this time. Each node creates two, as far as I know, flowers, or one. I'm not sure if three, but maximum two flowers. And I do see that every node has two buds developing, hoping they will not blast. But this year, I will have a much better show than what I had. Last year, I think he skipped blooming. 2 years ago, or actually 3 years ago, it bloomed again with two flowers, and then we had the first blooming. Oh my god, this guy is 5 years old or something. I'm actually gonna celebrate 5 years of YouTube this year. Yeah, it shall be great. Maybe we're gonna do the giveaway then. That's a good excuse. So this guy, as you can see, looks spectacular, and I cannot wait for him to bloom because the flowers are worth it. They're not very fragrant, and they're not very colorful, to be honest, but they're just so pretty if you see them in person. And I'm gonna be filming with this camera. Hopefully it's gonna be a beautiful video. But yeah, my Aphyllum is actually doing great. Okay, next up, a Cattleya, which I don't think I've ever filmed except when I received it. This is one that my mom sent me, I think, in 2015. No, in 2016. Oh, my brain is fried. So in 2016, my mom got me this, and she did so because I went through that little crisis with the fusarium. I got super scared that I am actually going to lose my collection. I was a bit of a mess because I just moved here. Mentally, I was in a very bad place in my life, to be quite honest with you. It wasn't because of the orchids and the fusarium. It was everything at once. It was, what am I gonna do with my life? Did I? I'm not gonna go into the details, but yeah, this is an orchid my mom sent me together with two more, which I still have, another Cattleya and a Phalaenopsis mini mark, which you will see in bloom when he blooms. He has a flower spike. But this one, I actually never filmed her because she never actually did much. It's one of those Cattleyas which grows slow. It is a bifoliate, so maybe that has something to do with it. It grows very slow. She didn't have much root system when I got her. Now she's sturdy in her pot. She's growing a new growth, and I think I see another one in the back. Not sure when she's gonna bloom. It's just one of those Cattleyas which take forever to bounce back. You know how it is. If you get a stress Cattleya, you kind of need to wait two growths for it to bounce back. Yeah, well, if those two growths are both formed in 1 year, you're good. If not, you're not good. You're gonna wait forever. And this is one of them. She looks okay. She produced these growths last year. They had a sheath, but the sheath didn't produce much. And it's just one of those orchids which has a lot of sentimental value to me because it's my mom, because of the period in which I got her, and so on. Sadly, it grows very slow, but she's beautiful and I cannot wait to see her in bloom. I do have the other orchids as well. It's just that this one, we didn't even talk much about it. We didn't even acknowledge we had it. And there we go, this is her spotlight. And the last orchid we are going to look at today is not a very old orchid, but it's one that I'm very happy with. I got her from Ana Maria last year. I purchased it through her from a flower shop in Romania, and I'm not sure what it is, but it is a beautiful orange red brick type of Oncidium intergeneric. Now, these types of Oncidiums don't do particularly great in my climate, or they take a little while because they are Odontoglossum hybrids, and Odontoglossums just happen to like more cool temperatures. They are hardy enough to be okay in higher temperatures as well. They just take a while to get adjusted and to be okay. And this one, I didn't really know if he will make it. He got really, really, really shriveled at some point, but he's doing great now. He has a pseudobulb which is super plump. Root-wise, not yet there. I do see some things that I need to cut, but we do have quite a lot of new roots forming. And of course, we do have roots inside the pot. because the pseudobulbs have plumped up. So I'm happy to say that he made it. With these intergenerics, I'm a little bit scared in my new climate. In my older balcony, it was a little bit better, not as good as with the proper Oncidiums. Those are very hard to kill, but these guys, they're a little bit more finicky. I know they're all reclassified as Oncidiums right now, but to my eyes, there's a clear distinction between the Odontoglossums and the Multonias, because yes, some intergenerics have been reclassified from the Multonias to Oncidiums. Yeah, it happened. Even though they're all Oncidiums, to me, they will always be Miltonidiums, Colmenaras, things of the sorts, because I already know what to expect. When it comes to the Odontocidium, do you remember that name? When it comes to these guys, I know I'm going to get the shriveling pseudobulbs, go through the motions, have to be patient with them, that's just how it goes. But the Sherry babies, I think you've already noticed, they're pretty indestructible, unless they have a problem. These guys though, they're a totally different thing. Luckily though, I managed to save mine, so fingers crossed he will bloom soon. He has a beautiful color and I cannot wait to see him. Alrighty guys, and this has been the video for today. Thank you for watching. I shall now go and medicate myself, and fingers crossed we're gonna be a lot better tomorrow so we can do the video that I keep promising you with the fertilizing. I'm sorry. But I hope you've enjoyed this. Let me know down below if you remember other very old orchids which you didn't see in a while. So alrighty, you know the drill. If you've enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you hated it, give it a thumbs down. Subscribe to my channel for regular orchid videos. And don't forget to turn on notifications so you never miss a video. And with that said, I'll see you all next time. Bye!